Hello everyone, I am Subhasmita Barad. Welcome you to first geology lecture video. In this video I am going to talk about rock deformation and concept of stress and strain. What is deformation? Deformation is change of original shape or dimensions or position of a rock body in response to stress. So if you have a stress, that is force, on a rock mass, then it changes its original shape or position. Then it is called deformation. Rocks are so hard, so we cannot change their shape by hand or applying huge amount of force. But to the contrary, nature can create huge forces that can act on a rock and can change its shape or position. Therefore, it can deform by stress or force. In that case, what is stress? Stress is intensity of force, that is pressure or force by area, or the forces that deform rock. Deformation only occur whenever the stress acting on a rock is greater than its strength. But the strength of rock exceeds the stress, then deformation will not occur. I am giving you one example that we can easily break a chalk by hand, but we cannot break the bricks. Why? Because the strength of the brick is greater than the stress of applied by our hand. Then comes to the stress components and types of stress. There are two types of stress. First is your confining stress, then differential stress. Confining stress means uniform stress in all direction, means changes occur same in all direction, or you have equal stress in all direction. Second one is your differential stress. Differential stress is the unequal stress in all direction, that is changes in the one direction that is not same in other direction. In this topic we are more concerned with differential stress, because due to differential stress, geological structure like fold, fault, joint, rock cleavages are formed. Then comes to fold. Fold is a structure of bending rock strata. When the rock is in right position according to force, then fold is formed due to stress. What is fold? But when the rock is not in the right situation or position, then it will break if the rock is solid or brittle. The one part of the broken body is move upward and another move downward, that is called fault. Then comes to the joint. Joint is the first stage of fault. If the broken part of a rock do not move, then it is called joint. So the difference between the fault and joint is, in fault broken part of the rock is move, but in joint broken part of a rock do not move. Lastly, you get rock cleavage. We know rock consists of minerals and crystals. Minerals and crystals have definite cleavage plane. If deformation occur in that cleavage plane, then it is known as rock cleavage. Then comes to the types of differential stress. There are three types of differential stress: compressional stress, tensile stress and tangential stress. First is your compressional or compressive stress. When the force is applied by a vertical column of a rock on a horizontal plane within the rock body, it is directed vertically. This is known as compressive stress, and this stress squeezing the rock body. In compressive stress, force is applied on a horizontal plane, but or when force is applied by on an inclined plane, that is Mn, vertically it is resolved into two components. Mn is the inclined plane, F is the stress force, and it resolves into N and T. N is your normal stress, T is your tangential stress. Normal stress can be of two types, that is also compressive and tensile. When it is called compressive? When two same force are acting each other, then it is called compressive force. But when two forces are pull apart the material on opposite side of the plane, it is called a tensile stress, opposite to the compressive strength. And this tensile stress enlarges the rock mass. Then comes to the shear stress or tangential stress. Shear stress acting tangential to the given plane, it represents force of tending to slide or shear the material in the plane. Last, couple stress, a system of two equal and opposite forces that act along parallel lines in the same plane without torsional effects. In ACBD, AC and BD two equal and opposite forces, same AD and BC are two equal and opposite forces. This is the square body and this is the rhombus body, and this is the strain effect. So, what is strain? It is the resultant of stress upon a rock, and therefore the deformation of rock caused by stress. It involves displacement of particles of the affected material, and stress is directly proportional to strain within the elastic limit. When stress is increases, also strain increases. There are two types of strain, normal strain and shear strain. Normal strain, when displacement along the line of force. Shear strain occurs when displacement of particles right angles to the line of force. There are two special type of strain, that is dilation and distortion. These two terms are very important for entrance point of view. Dilation means deformation occurs only in volume, or changes occur only in volume, but in distortion, change in both volume and shape. This is all about rock deformation and concept of stress and strain. This is the fundamental topic of structural geology. For this topic, you can prefer structural geology books by Satyanarayan Swami, S.K. Ghosh, Billings, and R.G. Park. Thank you.